Hey, I'm working on this crochet portrait. This is Larry, the dog that I'm working on for a fundraiser. And in this picture here, you can see why I turn my pictures on their sides. So I crochet from top to bottom, but as you can see here, let's see, there's his ear. This is his ear, so it will be turned this way. And I think it looks a lot nicer this way. So, and my colors, my swatches of yarn. I am on row 15. These little lines here don't mean anything. It just means that my pen was running out of ink, so I had to switch to a pencil. Let me put this aside. My yarn, all set up in my little yarn box. It was a do-it-yourself thing that I did a few months back. My pattern says, in color I, crochet 35. What I have done is I have crocheted 34 because I have to change the color now. So, for the 35th stitch, I will insert my hook and pull up a loop. Now, instead of finishing this stitch, I need to change colors. What I will do is I will cut, cross it off. I need to attach color H. Sometimes, if I want to let go, I'll just pull it around so that it stays. And color H, holding it in my left hand. Bring it around to the back, hold it against the cut edge, and I bring it towards the front of the hook, and I hold it between these two fingers, and then hold it with my thumb, and pull it through. Then I tie it. Okay, so that color H, need to do one of color H. So there's one. I don't complete the stitch because I have to change colors again. So I cut it, cross it off, do one of color J. This is color J. Now I've got a nice little mess, don't I? Okay, color J. To the side between the two fingers, hold it with my thumb, pull it through, and tie it in a knot. Now, row 15 means that it's the odd side, and the odd side knots get left to the back. So I just leave it there like it was. One of the color J. Cross it off. Attach color I. This green color. To the left. Pull it around front of my crochet hook. Hold it with my thumb. Pull it through and connect the yarn. I is 4, so we'll do 1, 2, 3. There's 4. Cut the yarn, hold on to it so I don't lose it, cross it off, E is 2. I'll bring around color E, hold it to the left, hold it with the two fingers, and hold it with my thumb. Wrap it around and bring it through. Tie that. Okay, so E is 2. 1, 2. Cut the yarn, cross it off, attach color A. Bring it to the side, hold it with my thumb, pull it through, tie it in a knot. I usually cut these 2 to 3 inches long. If you want to weave them in or sew them in, you might want to make them longer. Color A is 1. Cut. Cross it off. F. 1 of F. Through and connect the colors by tying in a knot. YouTube has lots of instructions on tying different kinds of knots. It's just what I do. F is 1. Cut the yarn. Cross it off. Color B. Hold them together. Hold it with the 2 fingers. And then hold it in place with my thumb. Pull it through. Tie in a knot. Okay. 2 of the B. 1, 2. Cut, cross off, color F. Don't have to tie it real tight. Just try to keep your tension somewhat the same so your stitch doesn't get pulled real tight. And F is 1. And attach G. G is 2. Cut the yarn. Oh, see, I made a mistake. I said G is 2, and I only did 1. Well, guess what? I just have to reattach it. So you're used to doing just ones. Okay, so here we go. Okay, now we have 2 of G. Cut the yarn, cross it off, and attach color A. Color A is 1. Got the yarn, cross it off, attach color H.